32-year-old Jamela is cooking away on the streets of Jakarta, selling fried snacks to provide for her family of five. Her hopes for the Indonesian economy are like so many others. I want my business to grow for more job opportunities and lower food and fuel prices, she says. Indonesia's next president is stepping into an economic quagmire. Departing President Susilo Bambang Yudhoyono leaves a slowing economy with huge trade and budget deficits, but it's not all bad.
It has the people, it has the resources, it has a favorable demographic, it has rapid urbanization, and it has a rising middle class. And it has very good macroeconomic management. I think those are ingredients that really can lift the country.
The two candidates, former military general Prabowo Subianto and Jakarta Governor Joko Widodo, have both promised economic growth, more jobs, roads and funds for education and healthcare. But analysts want to know how they'll pay for it and if they'll make unpopular cuts. The next president's first order of business, according to many analysts, is to make further cuts to the nation's roughly $30 billion in annual energy subsidies, which means hiking fuel prices.
It's leaving a fiscal time bomb to the next president. And the longer the time bomb, the bigger the explosion will be. And therefore, the bigger the magnitude of the fuel price hike will be.
Indonesia was a major exporter of raw minerals, but with the global commodity market down, it now needs to rebuild industry and manufacturing. But foreign investors are worried about the rise of protectionism. Both candidates have promoted policies aimed at adding value to the country's exports and protecting natural resources, sparking controversy.
These deficits have to be funded primarily by foreign investors. So when a country is running a big current account deficit, that country cannot be jingoistic, nationalistic, anti-foreign, because that country needs foreign investment.
And those are just the immediate challenges. The new president will also need to focus on employment. A recent World Bank study says Indonesia will need growth rates well over its current 5 to 6% to provide jobs for the 15 million Indonesians expected to enter the workforce by 2020. Without that, a new generation of Jamelas will find it hard to make ends meet. Anna Corrin, CNN, Hong Kong.